Hi guys, so I thought we'd have a bit of fun today. Trying to paint like Bob Ross. So what he has said is put brown into the corners and green. He said a light, just a light layer of green, although I don't know how he managed to do that. So to me, the green and the yellow might come out different. But let's see how that goes. So this is, oops, this is what he is saying. Just make some bushy shapes. Interesting. Yellow on green. Oh, let's see. Yeah, I'm a little worried about this. Oh dear. Let's just see what's going to happen. Don't know how this man does this, but I'm a traditional artist and to try and get this, do it the way he does it is quite interesting actually. Oh dear. I don't think this is really working out like his. I think it's in the wrist somehow. And he goes quick too. Oh dear. I can't do this. Oh my word. Just try and do my best. Get this cushion. Oh dear. Okay. Honestly. I think this is takes a lot of practice. Right, he says to keep the back here a little darker. I see mine is already too yellow. Oh dear. And I'm trying to keep up with him. This is so funny. I don't think my hand goes like his. Oh dear. Yeah. I don't know how this man does this. Maybe after doing this like I don't know, 100 times should come easy. But holy moly, it's a lot of work to do like this. Okay, I think we've got to have the right arm movement. Just tone that down a bit, because that's a bit on the bright side, I reckon. Hang on a minute, this man is so far ahead of me. Well, I've been doing oil paintings for a long time, and in all honesty, this is hard work. I don't know, guys. Does it look like anything yet? It's supposed to be like bushels. I can tell you one thing though, my arm feels like it's going to fall off. Oh, it's a bit bright there. Let's go this way, see what's going to happen here. So he says to keep some little dark areas, obviously, because that's going to make, create some depth. Rightly so. But man, mine doesn't look anything like his. Credit where it's due, that's for sure. I'm going to put a little bit more green into that. Sub green, because it's kind of like a little bit overpowering for there. Oh my word. Tell me if you guys have tried to do a Bob Ross painting before and how that went for you. Because honestly, as you can probably see, some not easy. Like I said, it'll probably, you know, take a few tries before you get the hang of doing it the way he does it. I must say, it's pretty effective. It's just, yeah. I need to try and make this a little bit more looking like trees, I think, opposed to kind of like a little weird there. Get a bit more dimension. Maybe I can go this way. Oh dear. He makes it look so easy. He just scrubs it on, and I don't know how he gets that effect, really. Sorry about that, guys. Happens at the worst of times, isn't it? Or the best of times. Okay, I think I need to move on to the side here. You're getting a bit too low down there. What do you think, guys? Is it coming along? It's a bit scary trying to paint like this. You're not used to it. Drop some comments below on what you think, and oh my word, if you've ever tried to do a Bob Ross. Okay, I think we're going to go in a little bit lighter here, because we're getting a little bit more forward in our painting, so we do need it to be a little lighter as you go forward. That of course is helpful for me because I have done art for a very long time, so I kind of do know that already. Oh, and this thing was in the way. We'll have to come back there. Maybe it's coming together. Make a big push here. That's looking cool. I think probably the secret is not to try too hard. There's a little difficult, I must say. It's not easy doing a painting like this, but I can see how it would definitely be quicker, that's for sure. I mean, this would definitely take like forever and a day if you were just doing it the traditional way. A little bit more light here. Holy moly, I think I'm getting it. Let's put some light over here. Oh my word. Too much dark around here, I think. Do you think it looks like bushes yet? Sorry about that banging, I've got no clue what that is. Hope it goes away soon. Oh yeah, I think it's okay, it's coming along. Oh dear, I'm very slow. I think I might want to put some more light over here. Hey guys, I know it's not going to look exactly like Bob Ross, but first attempt. Coming along nicely. Try and put a bit more light over here. That can be dark. Right. Ah, okay, he's got sticks going on already. Okay, so before I start putting some sticks in, I feel like I need to finish this here. We need some very thin brown. And put in some sticks. And some sticks. Yeah. I don't know how fast I can catch up because he's pretty quick. Oh dear. My word. He's so far ahead of me. Maybe we'll put one there. Okay, I think that I need to catch up a bit. I think it looks pretty cool. Right, so now we're going in with some land, the brown, crimson, and some white. Oops, it might be a bit too much. We're just gonna put some land here. Make this a little bit dark over there. And some land here. Oh dear. This is stressful, I must tell you. I know it shouldn't be, it should just be fun. But I guess trying to follow somebody else and what they do and how they do it is because I suppose because it's a challenge, really. Just put some more land in here. It is a little bit fast. Slow down, Bob Ross. Slow down. Oh. I want to make this a little darker in here because it's really in the shadows. Holy moly. Back into the yellow. Down straight, he said. That's not going to work very well. This is to bring some of that brown down into the water. Is a good idea, and then go across. Oh dear. It's quite a challenge, guys. Let me know if you've tried this and if it's worked for you. Let's get some in there. He doesn't seem to have lines. Oh dear. Honestly, I commend Bob Ross for what he did with all his paintings and how he taught people. It's amazing. Okay, I'm going this way now. That looks better. Sweet. Maybe I'm getting there. Right. Put in a bit of yellow across like that so it makes a water line. It makes it look so easy. Fun though. It is fun. It's just takes a bit of getting used to, I think. So much paint. Something is not right over there. Right, so now we have to go back in here and put some more lighter grassy bits. Get rid of this part here as well. Something's not right there. Oh dear. Interesting outcome. I think it's coming together. Okay, maybe I shouldn't go over that too much more. It's making mud. Maybe this is going to be a happy accident. Let's hope so. Right, so now we have an island. I don't think his was quite as big as this one. Okay. Gonna put a bit more of this together. I want to do this part here a little darker, considering it's the front and there shouldn't really be too much light source. Holy moly. Okay, guys. Next stage is more bushies. To be honest, I'm a bit worried about going into this brown here. Ooh. Might turn out very muddy. Okie dokie. Oops, and that is what I was afraid of. The brown. Put a little bit of white, give it a bit of sparkle. Oops. I need a different brush for that. I think we're getting there. I think it's looking quite cool. I need to go back in there with the yellow. it's coming together now. It's not perfect by any means. Put some there too. It's a little lonely in that space. Right. Let's get this going. So he has some land over here. Do it a bit more dark, actually. I get as much dark in there in the front as I can. Right. Now, back to putting some happy little trees in. Like Bob Ross says, you gotta give him a little mate. A little buddy, I think he said. Okay. Some bushy bushes. So I've just changed over my fan brush because that other one is so full of greens and browns and God knows it's a mess. Okie dokie. What do you guys think so far? I think I'm gonna put a little bit of green over here as well. It's all I can say. Okay, so he wants to go in with a little bit of white on the sides of the tree. Oops. Holy moly. I must say, I am so tempted to put my hand on the painting. Then we'll have a big mess. I'm just trying to cover up some of this white. Honestly, too much white. I tell you, my nerves are shot. This kind of thing makes me nervous. Let's put some bushy bushes here. Cover that up there. Sweet. Oops. Don't do that. Okay, come back. My brush. Oh, okay. So when I have a really big tree coming in. This is one big tree, this. Big, big, big tree. Make him stand a little bit bent and put a big tree trunk in there. White. Actually, I use this white and brown and put some light on the side. Oh yeah, that's actually looking much better. Okay. Right. So now we're going in with a darker green. And I'm putting some bushes in here. I don't want to go into here right now, because you know what's going to happen. Right. Now I think I will. Because then I can just wash my brush off. Oops. Is that looking like a happy painting? Wowee. I have to put some yellow up here. Add a little bit of brightness. Honestly, I can take my hat off to this man. Let's get a little bit of brightness, happy yellow here. Just a bit. I don't want to overdo it because, you know, bushes are far away. I might just put a bit here. Over those branches. Oh. Wait a minute. Didn't tell me that the tree didn't have, it was naked. It's got no branches or plants or leaves or anything on it. And I nearly left it like that too. A bit more darker green here too. So we don't want it to be too all yellow. And then I can put some more brightness on the top, just a bit here and there. Well, guys, I hope you've enjoyed this. It's been quite a journey, I reckon. I hope it's fun for you, and that you can also try, if you haven't already, really differentiate between the bushes and the tree, really. Make this a little more dense, because honestly I feel like it's just too open. Okay, guys, I think we're about done. I think before we go, I might just add here. Make some water here. It doesn't look so barren. Well, guys, thanks for watching. It's been quite a challenge, I must say. If you enjoyed this and you want to try it, check out Bob Ross's channel and leave a comment below. And thank you so much, guys. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring you down from there to show you a bit more closer. It would actually be nice if I had a little bit more light in here. Thank you for watching, guys. See you next time.